foolish. But look at the text. When you go to verses 25 and you go to verses 27, we find something else that's similar, because we see the structure. They both had structures, right? And God has given us all something to start with. And here he says in verses 25 and 27, it says, and the rain descended, the floods came, and the winds blew. Repeat after me, the rain descended, the floods came,
and the winds blew.
Now you know it's in the Bible because you just read it, right? So watch me. The rains descended, the floods came. You got the watchman out. And the winds blew. You got to look at me because I want you to see me. Don't look at your paws and your ass. Look at me. And then you can go back to it. The rain descended. The floods came. And the wind blew.
One more time.
The rain descended. The floods came. And the winds blew. They had trouble from the top, trouble from the bottom, and trouble out of the top. And that's what you call a storm. And just keep on living. You haven't had a storm yet. Keep on saying good morning. Because storms have a way of finding what we need. They had trouble on every side. Fact of the matter is, the text says that the rains descended, floods came, wind blew, and look what they did. They didn't just mind their own business. They beat up on that house. Am I right, children? And I tell you what, that's what trouble will do and storm will do. Storm will beat up on your lives. Some of you are going through something right now. I see the knot on your head. I'm talking about your spiritual head. I see the sleep in your eyes. You haven't been able to sleep all night long.
Oh yeah.
Because the storms were raging so high. Your knees are raw because you stayed on them praying so long.
Amen.
But if they're going to tell you that the Lord is like this.
Yeah.
In a time of a storm.
Amen. Come on now.
Just ask the Lord. Lord, please stand by me.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I think I got just about five witnesses who can testify this morning that you've been in a storm before. Somebody this morning can testify that you've been through a terrible storm. The fact of the matter is that somebody knows they're in the midst of one right now. You walked in here feeling fine and looking pretty good. But the truth of the matter is you're in a storm. And you're here trying to get some help. Well, I got good news for you this morning. That your help is already here. Do I have a witness in here? If you are in the midst of a storm, Lord, that you serve is able to see you through. Is there anybody in the room this morning?
Bible says in the word of God that the wise man, because he heard what the Lord said, and not only did he hear what God said, but he obeyed the word of God. And when the storms came and beat upon his house, that his house, because it was founded upon a rock, it did not fall. But the one who built his house on the sand, he was a foolish man. He was not a wise man, because he did not build his house on the rock. And when the storm of life came, his house fell. Why is it that the other man's house did not fall? Because he was founded on a rock. And what is the rock? This rock is Jesus. Can I get a witness in heaven? Ooh, this rock is Jesus. And somebody say, when you talk about Jesus, Jesus is the word of God.
Word. Can anybody here testify that the power is standing on the word? That a friend when standing on the word, you can lay down at night. When you stand on the word, you can sleep at night. When you stand on the word, you can rest at night. When you stand on the word, is there anybody here who's stood on the word? Is there anybody here who knows the power in the word of God? Is there anybody here who knows the power in the word of God? Hallelujah to the word of God and the hold on to the word of God. For the grass withers and the flower fades. But the word of God shall stand forever. Stand on the word. You ought to tell three people to stand on the word. Stand on the word. When it gets rough in your life, stand on the word. When it gets tough in your life, stand on the word. If you can't think of nothing else, just say, Lord, you are my shepherd. Tell the Lord, will you walk with me? Will you hold my hand? Will you help me stay? Stand on the word. If you stand on the word, heaven and earth shall pass away. But God's word shall stand forever. Can I get a witness in here? Stand on the word. Is there anybody here who's standing on the word? Is God holding your hand? Will God rock you in the middle of the night? Will God wrap your hand on? Will God give you peace? Will God supply your needs? If you know the Lord will, you ought to give God the praise. If you know the Lord will, you ought to bless his name. If you know the Lord will, glory. If you know the Lord will, you ought to give him praise. If you know the Lord can, you ought to bless his name. I need about 10 people who are not ashamed, who are not embarrassed, who are not too proud, who are not too cold, who are not too ashamed. So just give God a praise and praise. Give God a radical praise. Just praise the Lord like you lost your mind. You ought to praise the Lord like you're losing your mind. Like you're going crazy. You ought to bless the Lord like you've already done it.
My wife had gone and them had all of it gone to a mine. blessing of fine arts thing yesterday. And I was just at home by myself. And I was doing some things with the word of God and said, oh Lord, I started to change it. So Nick, I started just to go to the other one. He said, no, you stick with this. You know, sometimes you got to hear God. You got to listen. You got to listen. And I got the sermon title just yesterday, How to Keep Standing. Yeah. In the bottom. Call it out. Me. Some of y'all heard of God. We got a call last night, late last night, about 10:45, 10:30, almost 11 o'clock, and my mother's only last living brother went home to be with the Lord. He just died unsuspectedly, and he was gone. And when my cousin called and said how upset everybody was, keep on playing. This ain't no sad story, but God doing something. I didn't know how God was going to do that. I felt like I would be torn to pieces. And I don't have to be drug in the church. When the bottom falls out, my bottom may not be your bottom, whatever your bottom is. Whatever it falls out, you don't have to have somebody to stand on. He came and he died for our sins. Fact of the matter is, he shed his blood for our sins. He hung on a cross to give us power and deliver us from sin. That's what he did for us. Isn't that good news? I don't know about you, but I'm glad that he died and rose again. Just for my sins. Anybody else glad that he died for me? Anybody glad that he loves you enough to die for you? Doesn't matter who you are, where you're from, what kind of car you drive, what kind of house you live in, what kind of job you have or don't have. God loves you. No matter what you've done in your past, he came for you. Fact of the matter is, ain't nobody around here got halos on. For the record says, all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. But we don't have to stay where we are. He came to deliver us through the power of the cross. Here's what's about to happen today. If you're here, you need to be saved. That's important. That's paramount. If you don't know the Lord personally, you need to get to know him personally as your Lord and Savior. You need to have a relationship with the Lord. This time is for you. This is a good place to go to heaven from. If you want to be saved, you can be saved today. If you want to rededicate your life to the Lord, you've been saved, you walked away from God, you walked away from his calling in your life. He's calling you this morning. If you're here, you need a church home.